Okay, so yan, magandang gabi yung mga master, no? So welcome po sa ating pangpitong, no? Pangpitong session for our refresher, no? On our on your exam, no? Coming exam for RME, no? Which is which will be on April 28, no? So sa gabing ito ay ating pag-uusapan ang tungkol sa motors and motor controllers. So yung kanina yung medyo maaga-aga nakapag-login, so nagpa-play ako ng video, no? That is a YouTube video about the basic principles of DC motors, no? DC and AC motors, no? So if you want to view that or to watch that video, no, gusto niyo panoorin yun, so ipopost ko din yung link nun, no, sa ating Google Classroom, no? Okay, so simulan natin ang discussion for this evening. So we have motors and motor controllers. Okay, so we have a motor. So a motor is a machine, no, which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. So it is the opposite of the generator, no? Sa ating last na session, so we discussed about what is a generator. So a generator is a machine, no? A rotating electrical machine which converts mechanical, no? Mechanical energy to electrical, no? Kino-convert niya yung mechanical electrical to electrical energy, no? Well, the motor naman is the exact opposite, no? So, ano siya? The opposite of a generator, in which our input is an electrical energy, tapos yung output natin is mechanical energy. So, yung shaft, no? So sa shaft ng motor tayo kumukuha ng input, in which we are going to use that shaft, no? The rotating motion, in which we call that one as torque, as a way para makapag operate ng another machine, for example like the electric pan, or like a grinder, or like a drill, no? So yan yung pinaka purpose ng ating electric motor. So we have the speed torque characteristic of a DC motor, no? The speed of a DC motor is directly proportional to the back EMF and inversely as the flux generated per pole. So ito yung ating formula niyan. So the speed, so that is our N, the unit for our speed is RPM, no, revolutions per minute. Tapos yung ating E sub phi, that is our back EMF or counter EMF. Then our phi, so this is our flux generated on the poles, and our K is the proportionality constant, at which in some cases, so that will just be equal to 1, no? Then we have the torque, no? So the torque exerted by a DC motor is directly proportional to both the armature current drawn and the flux generated per pole. So we have this one, no? So our T is equal to K. Then I sub A, this is our armature current, times our phi, which is our flux, no? So we have here torque, no? The usual unit for torque is Newton meter, no? Our armature will be amperes. So our flux generated, it could be in Weber or in Maxwell's. Then our constant of proportionality, so sometimes it is equal to 1, no? It is usually equal to 1. Then we have the speed of a motor, with this is what we call as the synchronous speed, no? The synchronous speed. So this is the other term for the speed, no? So we have the RPM is equal to the F, no? Our F here is the frequency times 120 over P. So the 120 degrees is, that is the usual, no? The usual electrical degrees between our coils, no? So if sa previous video, yung kanina naka-play, so it is explained there that the coil, the coil per phase is 120 degrees apart from each other, no? So kaya meron tayong 120 dito. So kaya meron tayong 120. Tapos yung P natin, that is our poles, no? Number of poles. So this is very useful, no? Na formula kasi kadalasan itong hinahanap, no? So exam lang sabi, what is the speed of a motor? So ito yung formula, no? Then we have types of DC motor according to connection. So ito hindi to shunt generator but shunt motor, no? So kasi yung types of motor at types of generator is magkapareho lang yan. So basically, kung ano yung circuit natin sa generator, ate lang i-reverse para maging circuit ng ating motor, no? So we have here the shunt motor. So the field armature windings are connected in parallel across the supply voltage. So this is our supply voltage, no? Ito. So kaya ito tinawag na DC because our supply is DC, no? DC. So our armature windings are connected in parallel. So in parallel siya across the supply voltage and also across our to field, no? Field winding. Tapos itong voltage source dito, ito yung tinatawag nating back EMF, no? Or our counter EMF, which is produced if our coil, no? Our armature coil is being supplied by a DC current. So nangyayari kasi ito, itong ating armature, ito yung magnetize. Tapos our field, sometimes the field is also a permanent magnet. So nangyayari ito kasi nagiging electromagnet to, then we could now rotate our rotor, no, by the principle of electromagnetic induction, no. So ito yung shunt, no, shunt motor. So if you are going to get, no, to get the back EMF, so we could say our back EMF, our EB is just equal to ito. So VS minus D, so that will be VS minus the voltage drop on our armature, no, armature current, the armature winding. So IA times RA, no. Then for this one, no, our that will be our armature, no, field current. So ating field current, so almost low lang yan, no. So because this field current is parallel to our voltage source, so VS over RSH, no. Tapos dito rin meron din tayong current dito, which is our IL, no, our IL. So we could get our IL, no, or we could get our IA, so the armature current, by subtracting our IL with our ISH, no. Tapos yung ating IL naman, no, siguro hindi natatawin itong IL kasi parang nagiging load, so IS lang, no. So that is the current from the source, no, from the voltage source. So this is IS. So kadalasang given diyan is yung ating power output, no, yung output daw ng motor, we will divide that one by our efficiency, tapos over the voltage source para makuha natin yung ating ating input current, yung IS. Okay? Then next we have the series motor. So series motor, the same with series generator. So our armature and our field are connected in series. So ito yung nangyari, no? So they're connected in series. Then the machine is used where the load suddenly comes and goes after some time. So meron tayong mataas na load variation. So ang ginagamit natin is series motor, or yung connection niya is series, no? Yung connection ng field at ng armature in series, or where constant speed is not essential. So ito yung ating ginagamit, yung series motor. So if you are going to solve for our armature current, so it is just equal to our supply current, no, or the current given by the supply voltage kasi naka-series lang. Tapos yung ating back EMF, so that is equal to VS minus IA, the armature current, that times the total resistance, no? Total resistance, which is RSE plus RA. Then we have long shunt, no? Long shunt compound motor. So same, ang circuit niya is basically the same with our long shunt compound generator. So except parang binaliktad na natin yung circuit. So the series field winding is connected in series with the armature and connected in parallel with the shunt field winding. So ito yung shunt field winding, ito rin yung ating series field winding, ito yung ating armature resistance or the armature winding. Tapos meron tayong back EMF dito. So if you want to solve for our VS, no? Ano, VS but EB, the back EMF. So that will just be equal to our VS minus our armature current times the armature resistance plus the series field resistance, no? We are going to solve for our shunt field current, so that is equal to VS over RSH, no? Kasi nakaparallel lang siya. If we are going to solve for IA, so IA is just equals to IS minus ISH, and our IS, so this is equal to the power output times the efficiency of our motor over the voltage source, no? So in a motor, the efficiency is also written on the nameplate, no? The efficiency, the followed current, the phase, no? And also the operating frequency. So nakalagay niyan sa nameplate ng ating motor, no? Next, we have the short shunt compound motor, no? So the series winding is connected in parallel, in series, well, series field winding with the supply, while the field winding is connected across the armature winding. Okay, so ito yung series field winding natin, naka-series yan sa ating supply. Tapos yung ating shunt field winding is naka-parallel sa ating armature, no? Ito yung armature natin. So naka, ano siya, naka-parallel. So if you are going to solve for our EB, no? Our EB. So our EB for this instance will be equal to VS minus the IS, no? IS times our RSE, kasi ito yung voltage drop niya. Then minus IA times RA, no? RA, the armature resistance. Then solving, if you are going to have our ISH, no? So ISH equal, is just equal to VS. No, di na pa to equal to VS kasi may voltage drop na tayo dito, no? So that will be equal to, so meron na kasi tayong voltage drop dito. So hindi na to siya talaga basically parallel, no? So ang mangyayari sa atin yan is this will just be equal to VS minus IS times RSE, okay, over ISH, no? Tapos yung IA natin, just that will be equal to IS minus ISH, and our IS, that is power output over the efficiency over the voltage supply or the VS. Okay, so yan yung apat na type ng ating DC motor according to their connection, no? So, pagkatulad din ng generator, so meron tayong shunt, series, long shunt, and short shunt compound motor. Okay? Next, we will go to types of compound motors according to methods of compounding use, no? So, katulad din ng sa generator, meron tayong under, flat, at over. So, sa atin namang ano, sa atin namang motor, so sa ating motor is dalawa lang. Meron tayong differential compound motor. So the series field winding is so connected so that the flux produced by it opposes the flux produced by the shunt field winding. So yung flux na na-create ng series field natin is on in opposition with our shunt field winding. So this is this type of connection is used for a better speed control ng ating motor. So if you want to have a better speed control, so ang connection niyan is differential compound motor. While if you want to have a high speed, no, high speed mabilis, so ang ginagamit is the cumulative compound motor. So the series field winding is so connected so that the flux produced, no, by our series field winding will assist the flux produced by our shunt field winding. So kaya siya tinatawag na cumulative kasi nag-accumulate yung ating flux, therefore resulting into a more faster, no, high speed na DC motor. Okay, then we have speed regulation for our motors. So this is the same for the speed regulation for our generators. So that will just be the speed at no load minus the speed at full load over the speed of full load times 100%. So just like in the DC generator, so it is better to have a speed regulation below 5%, 5 or below 5%. Meaning if you have a much higher speed regulation, so for example, at no load your RPM is equals to 1200 RPM, then naglagay ka ng load, so full load, so nagiging 600 siya yung RPM, so there is a greater difference, so 50% yung speed regulation mo. So ang ibig sabihin nun, yung motor mo kapag nilagyan mo ng full load is nagiging kalahati lang yung kaya niyang ibigay na output, no, yung speed output niya. So and as we know, because motors are rotating machine, importante yung kanilang speed output at full load, no, kasi yung speed output nila yun yung nagdi-determine ng kanilang torque. So if their speed output is higher, so their torque is mas mataas, so mas madami-dami yung nagagawa nila, no. For example, if we want to have a motor na ilalagay natin sa drill, na yung drill kaya niya yung mga heavy duty na mga trabaho, so dapat mas mabilis yung ating RPM, no, ng ating motor. At kaya dapat mas mabilis, so dapat din mas mababa yung ating speed regulation, no. Okay, next we have DC motor starting, no. So at starting, the motor draws high armature current. So during starting, our armature current is very high. So the reason for this high starting current is our back EMF. So ito. Itong ating back EMF. Since at starting its value is equal to 0. To reduce starting current, a starting resistor, so may nilalagay tayo na rheostat, is connected in series with our armature. So dito natin i-connect yung ating rheostat, no. So because the purpose of the rheostat is to change, no, the armature current para hindi magkaroon tayo ng high starting current, no. So ang ginagawa ng rheostat is to compensate for the high starting current. So in order for us to get the R, so ito yung ating formula, no. So we have VS over I start, so the armature current of the starting, tapos minus our armature resistance, no. So makukuha natin yung R natin diyan. So kapag sa exam, kapag sinabi na we need to compute for the value of our rheostat, so ito lang yung formula na gagamitin. So that problem will involve DC motor starting. Okay? Next, so we have taas yata to. So motor reversion, so that is if we want to reverse our motor. For example, the initial rotation of our motor is clockwise, no, tapos gusto nating gawin counterclockwise, no. So there are two methods, no, dalawang method lang ang pwede nating gawin. So una, that is to interchange, no, the armature winding. So ipagpalit natin yung armature winding. So yung kunyari ang ating ang condition ng ating armature winding, yung ating terminal 1 is positive habang yung ating terminal 2 is negative. So baliktarin natin yan. So ating terminal 1 will connect that one in negative, tapos yung terminal 2 is positive. So ang mangyayari dyan, yung ating motor is mag-reverse na ng direction ang kanyang pag-ikot. Or we could also change the field winding, no. So same pa rin. So ang yung nakakonect sa positive, i-connect mo sa negative. Yung nakakonect sa negative, i-connect mo sa positive. And your motor will reverse, no? Reverse its rotation, no? So this is for DC motor, no? Then you have speed control. So the speed of a DC motor can be controlled by varying the resistance of a rheostat connected in series to any of the following. So una, yung rheostat natin is naka-series sa ating armature winding, just like when we are going to have our DC motor starting, no? Magsi-series tayo ng rheostat sa ating armature winding, or we could have also connecting the rheostat, no, in series with the field winding. So this is the most common method. So the question is, bakit pinaka-common? Kasi mas madali nating gawin 'yon, kasi yung ating field winding 'yon ang nasa stator. So hindi 'yun ang umiikot. So kaya mas madali nating lagyan 'yon ng resistor. Then the last one is rheostat in series with the supply terminal, no? So ito. So three ways na yan in order to control the speed of our motor. So we need, pwede nating ang rheostat naka-series sa armature windings, pwede naka-series sa ating field windings, which is the common method, or pwede rin naka-series siya sa supply terminals. Okay, next, we have the power rating of a DC motor. So the power rating of a DC motor is the maximum safest mechanical power it can deliver to the load. So kaya sinasabing mechanical power kasi, like I said, yung ating motor, it will convert electrical energy into mechanical energy, no? So P is equals to 2 pi, no? And T, our N is the speed, and our T is the torque over K. So K is the constant. So nakadepende yung T kung ano yung ating unit for our torque. So is it Newton meter or pound foot? So kapag Newton meter, yung ating gagamitin na value ng ating K is 44,760. Kapag pound foot naman, yung gagamitin natin is 33,000, no? Okay? Okay, so the standard rating for a DC motor. So we have 1/4, 1/3, 1/2, 3/4, 1, 1 and 1/2, 2, 3, 5, 7 and 1/2. So ito yung mga standard rating ng ating DC motors. Okay, so next, dito na tayo sa AC motor, no? So AC motor, so when we say AC motor, so ang ating supply is an AC, no? AC yung ating supply. So there are several types of AC motor according to their construction. So first, we have the squirrel cage type motor. So kaya siya tinawag na squirrel cage kasi para siyang ano, yung kanyang construction ng kanyang body, no, is parang yung wheel ng hamster, no. Kaya, ang tawag dun is parang wheel na kung saan pwede umiikot-ikot yung squirrel or yung hamster. So kaya tinawag siyang squirrel cage type na AC motor, no. So the rotor consists of aluminum bars located in slots in the iron core and connected to one another by means of heavy cast iron rings located on both ends of the core, no? Tapos meron yung wound rotor type, kung saan yung ating rotor, no, the rotor has windings that are connected to a commutator. So yung ating rotor ay meron siyang mga windings, no, na connected to our commutator. Then we have capacitor motors. So the Usual capacitor motors are single phase, no? Single phase AC motors. So there are single phase induction motor that uses squirrel cage rotor or a stator that has two windings called the main or run windings and the start or auxiliary winding, no? Kapag sinabi kasing capacitor motor, so yung windings niya dalawa yan, meron tayong starting at running winding. So this is the most common motors used in air conditioning unit, no? Yung mga window type na aircon. So ang ginagamit diyan is the capacitor start. Kaya nga yung ating air conditioning unit has may iba may single na capacitor, yung iba naman dual capacitor, no? So the direction of rotation of this motor is reverse, no? By changing, no? Interchanging the connection to the start or to the run winding. So kapag binaliktad natin yung connection ng ating running, no? Running winding, so yung rotation ng ating motor din is mabaliktad, or the starting winding. Kapag binaliktad natin yun, babaliktad din ating rotation, no? So the basic parts, so we have the rotor, stator, tapos yung brakes, no, in play or brackets, no. Then we have this centrifugal device, otherwise known as the centrifugal switch. Then we have the stationary switch, then one or more capacitor. So the purpose of this centrifugal device, so it is the device na magti-trigger. So siya yung magti-trigger sa ating switch, no? If for example our motor will reach its 70% or 60% of its speed, so mangyayari doon kapag naabot na niya 60 to 70% of its speed ay kanyang i-off, no? I-off yung switch, tapos ang mangyayari yung ating starting winding is magdi-disconnect na. So ang magpapatuloy lang ng ikot ng ating motor is the running winding, no? Tapos we have the capacitor start motor. So in this one, our capacitor is connected, no, on the starting winding. So an electrolytic capacitor is inserted at the start winding. So electrolytic capacitor. So the motor is equipped with a centrifugal switch that disconnects the start winding after the rotor has accelerated about 70% of its speed, no? 75% of its speed. So kapag umabot na ng 75% ng kanyang speed, yung ating rotor or yung ating starting winding is magdi-disconnect na, no? Tapos meron din tayong permanent split capacitor motor. So it is a capacitor motor having no centrifugal switch. So kapag walang centrifugal switch, ang tawag doon is permanent split capacitor motor. So it uses an oil filled type capacitor instead of an electrolytic type. So ang nangyayari dito, yung ating capacitor is hindi siya nagdi-disconnect, no? Regardless if lumagpas na ng 75% ang speed ng ating motor, no? Then we have two value capacitor. So a capacitor using different values of capacitance for start and running. So ang ibang tawag dito is capacitor start, capacitor run na motor, no? So may sariling capacitor for the starting winding, may sariling capacitor for the running winding, no? So yung tapos meron siyang centrifugal switch na pagkadating ng 75% na speed, yung starting is i-disconnect, tapos yung running na lang yung magdadala sa ating pag-ikot ng ating motor. Okay. Then we have repulsion start induction run motor. So this is one of the oldest forms of single phase induction motor and were widely used from 1930s through 1950s, no? So the rotor has a standard DC armature winding, a commutator specially designed, and a centrifugal mechanism for short-circuiting all commutator bars when the motor approaches its rated speed. So ang features ng ganitong klase na motor, so meron siyang high starting torque, so mataas yung kanyang torque, low starting current, then it is capable of doing well on low voltages, and most expensive of all single phase motors. So kaya hindi to masyadong ginagamit kasi It is the most expensive of all single-phase motors. Then we have the most common motor, no, na makikita nyo sa inyong bahay, lalo na kapag kayo ay may electric fan, no. So we have the universal motor. So it is basically a series DC motor which is especially designed to operate on single phase AC as well as DC supplies. So kaya tinawag siyang universal motor kasi pwede siyang mag-operate in DC and AC na supply. So the direction of the motor is reverse by interchanging the connection of the armature or the field windings, no? So this motor is used in portable tools such as electric drills, no? Tapos electric saws, etc. and in home appliances such as blenders, mixers, vacuum cleaners, and etc. So ang pinaka features nito, first it is high speed. So meaning if you want your motor to be high speed or yung gusto mong o yung application mo requires higher speed, so dapat ang gamitin mo is universal motor. Tapos ang isa din is small in size, no? Kaya siya pwede sa mga portable electric drills, tapos sa mga appliances, no? Then we have the standard rating for single phase AC motor. So we have this one, no? So we have the ang pinakamaliit is 1.6, habang yung pinakamataas naman is 10 horsepower. Kasi sa exam lumalabas yan. Which of the following is the standard rating of single phase AC motor? So ito. So ito yung mga standard rating nila, no? So ito din is makikita din to sa PEC, no? Kapag napunta na tayo sa motor feeder computation, so doon natin makikita kung ano yung equivalent na full load current per horsepower ng ating motor, no? Lalo na if we don't know what is the actual nameplate rating of our motors, no? So doon tayo magbabase sa table sa Philippine Electrical Code. So maybe on April, so madi-discuss natin yung ganyan, no? Yung about motor feeder computation. Then we have three-phase squirrel cage induction motor. So ito three-phase, no? So meaning yung supply natin dito is three-phase. So supply voltage is a three-phase voltage. The direction of rotation is reversed by interchanging any two-line terminals of our motor winding. Okay. So kapag three-phase kasi, meron tayong tatlong supply niyan. So kunyari ito yung ating supply, no? Tapos this is our motor here, no? So kadalasan diyan nilalagyan to sa ibaba ng ganyan symbol. Ibig sabihin niyan motor three-phase. Kapag gusto nating i-reverse to, no? So ito UVW, no? Tapos dito mo yung line 1, line 2 at line 3. If we want to reverse this one, so nangyari yung connection natin is line 1 sa U, line 2 sa V, tapos line 3 sa W. If we want to reverse the rotation, so ang gawin natin is ipag-interchange lang natin yung connection ng ating line 1 at line 3, no? Yan yung kadalasang ginagawa. So yung ating line 1 i-connect natin sa W, habang yung ating line 3 i-connect natin sa U. At yung ating motor is mag-reverse na siya ng connection. So that's why we have the forward reverse, no? Forward reverse na motor controller. So basically gumagamit lang tayo ng dalawang contactor in order to interchange our line 1 and line 3, no? So dalawang contactor yan. So we have sa forward natin na contactor, yung ating supply is 1, 2, 3 for our motors. Tapos pag sa reverse nagiging 3, 2, 1, kaya nag-reverse yung ating motor. Tapos we have one rotor induction motor. So katulad din yun sa single phase, except for this one, so the rotor core with 3 windings. So meron ng tatlong winding which is in place at the conducting bars of our squirrel cage motor. So the advantage of having windings in the rotor is the wires can brought out through the slip ring so that the resistance can be added and therefore current through the windings can be controlled. So the advantage kaya ang ginagamit ko last time is one rotor is that may control tayo sa ating current. No need to put rheostat, no, to compensate with our back EMF. So ang gawin na natin is maglalagay tayo ng winding sa ating rotor. So kaya one rotor induction motor. Okay. So ito yung mga standard rating of 3-phase squirrel cage and one rotor type AC motor. So ito. So ang pinakamaliit is 1/2 habang ang pinakamalaki naman is 200. So kaya ini-emphasize ko yung pinakamalaki na rating at yung pinakamaliit kasi yan din yung madalas tinatanong, no? So what is the minimum size, what is the minimum standard size for 3-phase induction type squirrel cage motor? So ang choice is 1/2, 3/4, 3/6, no? So ganyan yan. So pinakamaliit is 1/2 habang yung pinakamalaki is 200. So katulad din yan sa conduit. So what is the minimum size for rigid metal conduit? So meron nakalagay dyan. So ang pagkakaiba lang sa ano sa PEC is sa conventional, no, or sa kung babasihan natin yung NEMA, 1/2. Sa atin kasi is naka-metric tayo kaya sinasabi natin 21 mm, no? So yan yung pinagkaiba na ma-discuss din natin as we go on with the topic on Philippine Electrical Code, no? So medyo madami-dami yung kailangan tandaan, no, when it comes to Philippine Electrical Code. Then we have synchronous motor. So the basic parts are similar to a 3-phase synchronous generator. Then the motor is needs a DC voltage to excite the rotor winding. So the features, so under normal condition, it runs at a constant speed. And the most common use for synchronous motor is to improve the system power factor. If we don't have a capacitor, kung wala tayong capacitor to improve our power factor, no, or to increase our power factor, so we could use, no, kung natin gamitin ang synchronous motor, no, synchronous motor. Okay, so the standard horsepower rating of our 3-phase synchronous motor are this one. So we have 25 horsepower, which is the minimum, and the maximum is 200, no. Yung kanina sa ating ano ba yon, sa ating single phase AC motor, so yung maximum is 10 habang yung minimum is 1.6, no? Okay. So, naman tayo. Ito. So, now we will go to motor controllers, no? So, what is a motor controller or what is a motor control system? So, it is a system that controls the electrical energy used to run a motor and the majority of devices used to control the energy are in the motor control. So, yung motor control, basically, it will control the electrical energy, no? To make it much simpler, yung electrical energy is the electrical source ng ating motor. So why do we need to control the electrical energy, no? Because if we could control the electrical energy or yung supply ng ating motor, then we could control the motor itself, no? Kaya for example, if we want to have our motor not at a certain instance, kunyari sa pag-start ng motor natin, naka-reverse siya, tapos after few seconds forward, so ang gagawin natin, instead of opening the motor, tapos balik ta rin natin yung windings, no, gagawin lang natin is yung supply side na lang yung ating ating lalagyan ng mga devices in order for us to control the motor itself, no? So meron tayong dalawang klase ng motor control system. So first, we have the power circuit group. So these components carry the rated voltage and the current needed to operate or run the motor, no? So yan yung power circuit. So these devices commonly includes disconnects, power conductors, wires, fuses, circuit breakers, magnetic contactors, rigid metal conduits, overload heaters, and others, no? So yung ating power circuit group, so ito yung nakikerry ng rated current at rated voltage ng ating motor. So for example, if we have a box here na ito yung ating ano, ito yung ating power circuit. So ang dumadaan dyan na wire are exactly equal to the rated, no? Rated, well, kunyari yung ating ano supply is 30 amperes yung pumunta sa motor, so yung lalabas din dyan is 30 amperes, 30 amperes, 440 volts. So ito din 30 amperes, 440 volts, no? So yan yung power circuit, habang yung isa naman is what we called as the control circuit group. So these are components, no, necessary in switching power to the motor on or off under certain conditions. So the device includes the start and stop buttons or the push buttons, relays, limit switches, and other sensors, including the indicating devices, so pilot lamps, alarms, buzzers, among others, no. So ang control circuit, no, or the control circuit group, ang pinaka purpose dyan, no, in a simpler term is just a switch, no, switch lang talaga yan, no, switch. But the switch itself must satisfy the condition. So kung yari yung switch na to dapat lang mag-on after 5 seconds. So kasi meron tayong time delay, so dapat mag-introduce tayo ng timer relay, no, ganun lang yan. Or kailangan after 5 seconds naka forward siya, tapos habang naka ano after 5 seconds ulit naka reverse. So that's why mag-i-introduce tayo ng dalawang contactor na coil, no? Kung saan yung contactor na coil is yun yung magko-control sa ating contactor. So ganyan lang yung ano control circuit group. It is just a switch, no? Na in which yung switch na yun is magsa-satisfy certain conditions, no? So meron kasing tatlong kasi na switch, no, sa na yung tawag natin yan is the input device of our control circuit group. So yung una is the hand switch, no, hand switch. So ano ba yung hand switch? So example nito is push button, no, push button. So kunyari push button, so kailangan yung input is nanggaling sa kamay, no, that is push button. So meron din tayong process switch, no? Ano yung process switch? So the process switch is kailangan merong certain process, no, to trigger the switch, no. Ang example dyan is limit switch, tapos the float switch, no. Tapos meron tayong isa is the condition, no, condition switch. Kung saan itong condition switch will depend on the temperature, on the illumination. So yan yung nagko-control sa ating control circuit group, the input devices, no? Okay, then we have components of a motor controller. So ito yung mga basic components, no? So first we have the contactors. So these are electromechanically operated switch that provide a safe and convenient means of connecting and interrupting branch circuits, no. So pinaka-common contactor. Then we have the push buttons, no. So this type of hand switches are a two-position device operated with a button that is pressed and released. So what is the minimum number of push button required in a controller? So dalawa yan. Meron kang start, meron kang stop. That is the minimum number of push button in a motor controller. Dalawa, start at stop, no? Kasi it is not advisable to have only start button. Na kapag pinindot mo yung start button tapos pag gusto mong i-off yung motor mo is yung breaker lang o yung disconnect lang i-off mo. So it must have a start and a stop. Okay. Then we have the selector switch, no? The selector switch is in actuated with a rotary knob or lever of some sort to select one or two or more position. So usually the selector switch is used to transfer, no, to transfer the control of the motor, either automatic or manual. So yun lang ang purpose nun. So for example, if you want your motor to be controlled using the PLC, so i-set mo yung ano mo, yung selector switch mo in PLC. If you want it naman nga na ikaw yung mismo mag-input, so you switch the selector switch manually, na kung saan ikaw yung magpipindot ng mga push buttons, no? Then we have limit switches, no? So limit switches are operated by machine motion. So these are useful in automation and control application. So limit, no? So for example, if a certain height is reached, so the limit switches will either turn on or off. Then we have control relays. So these are used as auxiliary devices to switch control circuits and larger motor starter or contactor coils, and to control small loads such as small motors, solenoids, electric heater, pilot lights, and other relays. So the control relay, the so-called the little brother of contactors, no? So medyo maliit ka. Kadalasan yung ano, yung control relay is they have 14 pins, no? For 14, we have 16. Nakadepende kung ano yung application ng inyong control relay. So ang pinakagamit ng control relay is if we are going to control our circuit using PLC, no? Kadalasan yung ginagamit is the control relay. If we are only using our if you are going to use a controller which is manually, no, manual ating controllers, we will use contactors, no, kadalasan contactors. But if sa PLC na, so yung output ng ating PLC ay ating i-feed sa ating control relays, no? Tapos yung output naman ng control relays ay naka-feed sa ating contactors, no? Ganyan yung ano, basic hardware ng ating PLC, no? Then we have pilot light. So pilot light is a small mushroom-shaped bulb used as signaling device, no? So yung ilaw, no? So there are three or four main colors ng ating pilot light. So meron tayong red. Dapat siguro red yung kulay ng pen ko, no? So meron tayong red, tapos green, at yung isa, wala yatang yellow. Walang yellow sa pen ko. So yung isa is yellow or orange. So yung red, so that is top or idle. So ibig sabihin nun, hindi gumagalaw yung motor mo, no? Yung green is go, umiikot. Yung yellow or orange, that stands for fault, no? Fault. So, mayroon ding iba na hindi ginagamit yung yellow or orange na push button. Ang kailang kinoconnect is a buzzer. So, that is to signify or to give signal to the person in charge on the motor control na nagkaroon ng fault. Either overload or nag-single facing yung motor. So, kapag ganyan, so it needs to be disconnected from the system. So dapat i-disconnect. So kaya meron tayong mga indicating na mga pilot lights, no? Lastly, we have the timer relay, no? The timer relay delays, no? Timer delay relays are divided into two general classification: the on delay and the off delay relay. So the contacts of this relay on changing the position for some period of time. So kunyari, gusto natin na mag-on siya at 5 seconds. So, ibig sabihin yan, on delay yan, no? Tapos, pag off delay naman, initially, it is on, but after 5 seconds, it will off. So, yan yung off delay. So, yan yung mga components ng ating motor controllers, no? So, speaking of motor controllers, okay? So, ilan ba talaga yung klase ng motor controllers? No, ilan? So there are only two main types of motor controllers. Dalawa lang 'yan, no? So yung una is the ang una nating gamitin is the direct online or the forward reverse, no? Forward reverse, tapos yung pangalawa is the starters, no? So yung direct online, forward reverse, so these are motor controllers, so used to control the characteristic, no? Characteristic of the motor. When we say characteristic, kung yari yung direct online, ay gusto natin na yung ating motor is ma-off natin agad, on off. So ginagamit natin direct online. Pag forward reverse naman, so forward tapos reverse. So yan yung ating ginagamit pag we want to control the characteristics of our motor. If starters naman, we want to control how the motor start. So ito, how the motor starts. Bakit kailangan nating i-control ang ating starting ng ating motor? Because we have the so-called lock rotor, no? Lock rotor current. So ano yung lock rotor current? So this is the current or the amperes needed for our rotor to start moving. So dapat yan yung ma-supply na current sa ating motor para makapag-start na umikot yung ating motor. Ang problema niyan is that will require a larger amount, no? Larger amount of current. So kapag malaki ang current, anong mangyayari? So this is usually times 6, no? So between 3 to times 6 of our full load current, no? That is the nakadepende yung lock rotor current sa letter classification ng ating motor, no? Kung saan din makikita din yan sa Philippine Electrical Code. So times 6, no? Kung yari times 6, kung yari yung ating full load current is 10 amperes, no? So at starting, if we will assume that it is times 6, so magiging 60 amperes. Kaso yung ating wire is only rated at 10 amperes. So ano mangyayari sa wire natin? So our wire will overload. So siguro masusunog or in slight cases magiinit ng yung wire natin. So dapat kailangan nating lagyan ng starter. So there are starters used to start the motor na maliit lang yung current pero makapag-start na siya. Malaki na yung maibibigay na torque para makaikot na yung ating shaft, no? So there are basically three na pinaka common. So we have the primary resistance starter. Okay, so itong primary resistance at the start of the motor, so sa start na kapag nilagyan na natin ng supply ang ating motor, meron tayong nilalagay na series, no? Na series na mga resistor sa ating windings, no? Sa ating winding. So, nangyari is we could still supply the same current pero hindi masyadong hindi masyadong nalalakihan yung current na nalagay sa ating armature to prevent our armature from burning out or mag-overload. So, ito siya, primary resistance. Ang pangalawa naman is auto-trans or auto-transformer starting, no? Auto-transformer. Okay. So when we say auto transformer, so meron tayong kinonek na auto transformer sa ating motor, no? Which after siguro 10 seconds or 15 seconds ay madi-disconnect din. So itong primary at itong to auto transformer ang nagdi-disconnect nito sa ating sa supply ng ating motor is by the use of contactor or control relays. Tapos ang pinaka-common talaga is the Y delta starter, no? Okay, Y delta starter. When we say Y delta starter, so our motor will start in Y configuration, no? So So when we say Y configuration, so it is usually high voltage, low current, kasi equal yung phase current natin at yung line voltage. Tapos kapag okay na yung rotation niya, nakapag-start na, so maybe from 10 to 20 seconds, so yung ating winding naman using the contactor, so magiging formation niya is delta. At ang delta na yung ating running na winding, no? Okay, so ang tanong nito is, lahat ba ng three-phase motor pwede natin gamitan ng Y delta? So not all, kasi kadalas ang ano lang talaga is dapat yung winding mo can be arranged using Y or delta. So kadalasan dapat ang motor is 6 leads. Yung 6 leads, that is the usual, kasi yung motor mo, yung motor winding mo could be connected Y or delta. Yung iba din is 12 leads, no? 12 leads. Ang sa 12 leads lang, meron tayong tinatawag na high delta. So when we say high Y, the voltage na kailangan ng ating Y is mataas. Meron din tayong low Y na medyo mababa, no? Tapos meron din tayong high delta at low delta, no? So yan yung 12 leads. So meron niyang arrangement. So siguro yung arrangement nito is isasama ko na lang sa Google Classroom, no? But of course, wala naman sa exam na kailangan mong gumawa ng circuit for the 6 12 leads na motor, or you must create a diagram for Y delta, no? So that is only if gusto niyo mag-take ng NC3, ng EIM NC3. Yan yung meron talagang diagramming, or kung wala mang diagram, yung given man yung diagram, dapat mong i-interpret yung diagram. But sa RMA exam, so it is assumed that based on your experience, alam niyo na yung mga motor starters, no, or motor controllers, no. So ang pinakatanong kadalasan sa sa board exam is when it come to motor controllers or motor starters, ang tanong niyan is, if you are using a primary resistance starter, ilang resistor ang ilalagay mo? So of course, if you are using three phase, so dapat tatlo, no? Pag sa auto transformer din, ganun din, ilang auto transformer. Tapos sa Y delta naman, the minimum number of contactor to be used in making a Y delta starter, no? So ang tamang sagot niyan is 3. So dapat meron kasing main, meron kang delta contactor at Y contactor. But in practice talaga, pwede mong gamitin dalawa lang, no? Dalawa. Kaso yung ang gagawin doon is yung main is hindi mo na yon isasama. Yung main mo is naka-direct na lang, hindi na idadaan sa contactor. The only problem for that if your motor is malalaki. Nangyayari yung main mo is nag-i-spark, no? Yung main mo na hindi mo pinadadaan sa contactor, maaring mag-spark yun doon sa disconnect, no? So kaya mas mainam na gamitin talaga is 3, and that is also based on the Philippine Electrical Code. 3 naman talaga yung minimum for Y delta starter. Okay? So yan yung mga concept, no, for motors and controllers, no? So sa exam talaga is kung may computation man ito, is all about the speed. No, the speed of the motor or the armature current, long shunt, compound motor. The usual is on the concept itself, no? So sa controllers, ano yung mga devices, yung sa motors naman is ano yung gagamitin na motor on high speed application. So yan yung mga kadalasang tinatanong. If there are computations about the controller, so doon na yun lalabas sa PEC, na Philippine Ethical Code, na part ng exam, no? Kunyari, you are given a motor na 30 horsepower, yung kanyang letter classification is A. So dapat mong i-compute yung kanyang feeder, no? Yung feeder wire niya, tapos feeder protection, the disconnect, the size of the contactor controllers, no? So yun yung gagawin mo, no? But that is on Philippine Ethical Code na atin din yang i-discuss, no, as we go on with our refresher. Okay, so now we will go on to the practice test, no? So again, so just like what we did on our previous sessions, so yung ating practice test is meron tayong mga questions, multiple choice, na kapag gusto nyong sumagot, no? So you just write your questions on the chat box, no, ng ating Google Meet, no? Then after that we will answer, no? We'll answer our we will give the correct answer, no? Ibibigay ko yung tamang sagot ng ating sa ating mga tanong. Okay? So first we have this one. So we have, you have 2 minutes to answer. So what is the synchronous speed of a 60 cycle 4 pole AC motor? Okay, so you have 2 minutes to answer. So hindi ko na siguro i-share sa screen yung ano, yung tawag doon, yung stopwatch, no, kasi minsan naglalag, no. Okay, so may sumagot na. Okay, so you still have 1.5, no, minutes. Okay, so may dalawa ng ano, bigay ng kanilang sagot, no? Okay, so tatlo. So you still have 30 seconds, no? So kapag tumunog na yung alarm, so meron ng tatlong ano nagbigay ng kanilang sagot. So kapag tumunog na yung alarm, so that will mean the time is up, no? Okay. So tumunog na yung ating alarm. Okay. So the correct answer for this one is, so ay isosolve to natin, no? So we have the speed, our n is equal to f times 120 over p. Okay, so we have our f, no, 60 cycles, so that is 60 hertz times 120 over our number of pole, which is 4. So calculate natin niyan. So we have 60 times 120 divide 4. That is equal to 1,800. So 1,800 RPM. So yung answer natin is letter B. No? So congrats doon sa mga sumagot ng letter B, no? Next, what is the frequency of a 6 pole 1200 RPM motor? Okay, so you have 2 minutes to answer. Okay, so you have 1 minute and 40 seconds left, no, to get the frequency of a 6 pole 1200 RPM motor. capture this one, no? So, may maraming nagsagot ng A, no? Diba ito, bakit hindi mawala yung buzzer? Okay. So, we have here 6 pole 1,200 RPM. So, hinahanap natin yung frequency. So, N is equal to F times 120 over P. So, kapag ang hinahanap na is frequency, so, equals multiply natin yan. So, we have N times P over 120 is equal to F, no? So, ang N natin is 1,200 habang yung ating pool is 6, no? Over 120. Okay. So, let's answer na. So, meron tayong motor na ang kanyang kinukuha na power or power from our line is 4.5. So, that will be our power input, no? 4.5 kilowatts or 4,500 watts. Tapos, ang kanyang binibigay naman na power, that will be the output is 5 horsepower. So, gawin natin yung watts. So, that will be 746, no? I-multiply natin ang 746. So, we have 5 times 746. Okay? So, this will be equal to 3,730. So, 3,730 watts. Okay? So, the efficiency is equal to the power output over the power input times 100. So, meron tayong 3,730 watts over 4,500 watts times 100. Okay. So, mangyayari dyan, we have so 3,730 divide 4,500. Okay. Tapos, times 100. Okay. So, meron tayong 82.89, no? 82.89%. So, ang malapit-lapit dyan is letter B. So, our answer is letter B. Okay? So, next question. Okay. So, the voltage produced by electromagnetic induction is controlled by. So, it is controlled by the number of lines of flux cut per second, AD current, the size of the magnet, or the number of turns. Okay. So, ito kahit 1 minute lang siguro, kaya na itong sagutan, no? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter A, no? Letter A, the number of lines of flux, no? Cut per second, no? Kasi alam natin through electromagnetic induction, so the induced voltage is directly proportional to the number of lines, no? The number of lines cut, no? By our conductor. Okay, next. Permanent magnet use blank as the magnetic material. So, ano yung ginagamit? Especially for our permanent magnet ng ating motor, anong klaseng material yung ginagamit, no? For the permanent magnet. So, is it nickel, iron, hardened steel, or soft steel, no? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter C, hardened steel. Now, the hardened steel is used aside from its high na strength, high tensile strength, is also to, on the next one, is it is lower, no? Mas lower ang kanyang natawag nating ED, no? ED loss, no? Or also the hysteresis loss, kasi itong ibang ano, itong iron at nickel, so they are somewhat a higher permeability, so medyo mataas yung kanilang ano losses, while the soft steel naman the same material, steel pero soft siya, so hindi niya kayang ma-withstand yung ano yung strength needed, no, to hold the armature or to hold the windings of our motor. Okay, so kaya ang tamang sagot dyan is hardened steel. Next, the armature current drawn by any DC motor is proportional to the blank. Motor speed, voltage applied, flux required, torque applied. Okay, so let's answer this one, no? Kasi hindi naman to kailangan isolve. So the correct answer for this one is letter B, the voltage applied, no? So why the voltage applied? Because the principle of DC motor, so it is from electrical energy to mechanical. So meaning, yung lahat ng parameters na nasa loob ng ating motor will depend, no? Will depend on the voltage source, no? Kasi yung input natin is electrical. So yung flux natin, yung kung gaano kadami yung flux, yung bilis ng motor, that is always affected or always in relation with our voltage, no? Yung ating voltage source. So if in case this is a motor, so sa motor, no motor but generator, diba yung generator that is mechanical, no? Mechanical to electrical. Okay. So yung ating mechanical, this will be our prime mover, no? Lagay ko lang this is for generator, no? Kasi baka sa board baliktarin, no? So yung armature current on DC generator is proportional to. So baka ganun, no? Tapos ang sagot niyo voltage applied pa din, no? So iba na 'yon kasi yung ating input is mechanical, tapos naka-shafting 'yan, so prime mover sa ating generator, no? So ang tawag pala sa prime mover at generator kapag pinagsama 'yan, ang tawag diyan is genset, no? Generator set. Okay, so ito meron to ditong rotational force na ang tawag natin is torque. At kung gaano kabilis ating torque natin, yan yung nag-govern kung ano yung ating armature current, ano yung flux, ano yung speed ng ating generator, no? So kapag generator na itinanong, dito tayo sa torque, no? Kapag sa ano naman motor, dito tayo sa voltage applied. Habang itong motor speed at flux required is that is always affected by the input, no? Yung input kasi itong motor speed, ano yan, dependent yan sa ano mo, sa armature current mo, yung ating motor speed, no? At yung flux naman is sa ating ding armature current. Okay, next. Basically all motors operate on the principle of repulsion or blank. So alin dito? So magnetism, induction, resistance, capacitance. Okay. So madali lang 'to, no? So I guess this is the most easy, no, sa questions natin as of now, no, sa questions natin tonight. So the answer for this one is induction, no? So kaya nga sabi ko yung mga rotating machine like motors and generators, so the principle that we are using for that one is electromagnetic induction. So in short term, induction. Okay, next. Inductance in a circuit. So ito, parang sa easy lang yata to, parang review ng konti. So inductance in a circuit, blank. Delays the change in current, prevents current from changing, causes power loss, causes current to lead voltage. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter A, no? Delays the change in current. So dinidelay lang yun yung change in current, no? So hindi yan nag-i-store ng energy nor charge, but it delays the change in current. So ito na ang prevent current from changing, no? So there is no device, no, na gumagawa nito. causes power loss, no? So kadalasan nagko-cause ng power loss is the resistance, no, the reactance itself, but we need to have a frequency in order to create reactance. Then causes current to lead voltage, so that is the capacitor, no? Capacitor ang nagko-cause ng ating current to lead the voltage, specifically the capacitive reactance, no? So ang answer diyan is letter A. Next, DC series motor are used in application where blank is required. Constant speed, hard start, high starting torque, low no load speed, none of this. Okay. So DC series motor. So ano yung kadalasang pinagagamitan ng ating DC series motor? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter B. So the high starting torque. So if we need our if our applications need high starting torque, so we will use DC series motors. Okay. Next, the speed of a DC motor can be controlled by blank. So varying the armature current while the field current is held constant. Varying the field current while the armature current is held constant. Varying the armature voltage while the field voltage is held constant. Or lastly, varying the field voltage while the armature voltage is held constant. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter B. No, because your speed of a motor depends on the flux, and the field is the one who will create or have the flux. So if we have a higher field current, so mas marami yung flux mo, mas mabilis yung ano yung motor. So that's why we vary the field current. Then we held the armature current constant. Okay. So next we have a device that serves to govern in some predetermined manner the electric power delivered to the apparatus to which it is connected is called a blank. Okay, so anong tawag dito? Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter D, no, controller. So kapag sinabi kasing to govern or to control the electric power, ito talaga electric power or electric energy, no? So ang tawag talaga dyan is controller. So kapag sinabing a device used to control or govern the electric power delivered to a motor, so ang tawag natin dyan motor controller. But in general, ang tawag sa kanila is controller, no? Okay? So ito lang yung keyword, no? Govern or control electric power or energy. Yung iba naman, electric supply or source. So ang tawag dyan is controller. Next, to measure the RPM speed of a motor, you would use a blank. So alin dyan yung gagamitin mo? Hydrometer, bolometer, tachometer or odometer, no? So siguro ito ano din to sa topic natin sa testing equipments, no? Okay. So the correct answer for this one is tachometer, no? So itong hydrometer, this is for the specific gravity of our battery, while the odometer is the speed on your motorcycle, no? Yung bolometer, hindi ko pa yung masyado alam ko na yung bolo. Baka ano yan, used to measure the length of a bolo, no? Kaya bolometer. Okay, next, we have a motor with a wide speed range is a blank. So, DC motor, AC motor, synchronous motor, or an induction motor. Okay. So, parang medyo nahati yung mga sagot nyo ah. Okay. So, ano kaya yung tamang sagot dyan? Okay. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter A, DC motor. So mas madali nating i-control yung speed ng ating DC motor, kaya meron tayong higher speed range. So especially if our motors are connected, no, in series, no, we have the series motor. So mas madali nating i-control ang speed nun. Okay, next, a type of AC motor that runs at a constant speed and is used for such purposes as an electric clock is a blank motor. Okay, so squirrel cage, AC induction, wound rotor induction, or synchronous motor. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter D, no? Synchronous, no? The synchronous motor always run at a constant speed, kaya pwede siyang gamitin as a power factor corrector, no? For correcting power factor, or also as an electric clock because it runs at a constant speed, no? Next. So, ito, madali lang to. Now, motors of 1/3, 1/4, and 1/8 HP are connected in parallel. So, those motor deliver a total of blank. Okay. So, mabilis ah. Parang common na yata tong question na to, no? Tingin ko nasa pre-test din yata to. Okay, so if we are to get the total, no, power delivered by our motor, which is connected in parallel, so i-add lang natin yan. So 1/3 plus 1/4 plus 1/8, no? So i-add lang yan. Regardless if our motors are connected in series or in parallel, the total power consumed or delivered by those motors is still the sum, no? Or yung total ng kanilang power, naka series ba yan o naka parallel, the total power is just getting the sum, no? I-add mo lang yan at lahat ng ano, at yan yung magiging total power mo. So we have 1/3, no? 1/3 plus 1/4, no? Tapos plus 1/8. So the answer for this one is 17/24 or letter C. Next, fractional horsepower universal motors have brushes usually made of blank. Okay. So fractional horsepower universal motors. Okay. So ito, trick question kasi to, no? Trick questions. Trick. So kapag iniisip mo mabuti yung question, isipin mo ano kaya yung fractional horsepower universal motor, no? Okay. So the correct answer for this one is letter C, carbon. Now, bakit carbon? Because brushes are usually made of carbon. No? Yung brushes natin that is made up of carbon. Okay? So the correct answer is letter C, carbon. Next. A type of motor that will not operate on DC is the blank. Series, short shunt, long shunt, squirrel cage. Okay, so alin sa mga motor dito ang hindi mag-ooperate kapag ang supply natin is DC? Okay, so the correct answer is letter D, no? Kasi lahat to sila, itong series, short, and long shunt, these are the types of DC motor. Habang itong ating squirrel cage, so that is AC motor, no? So, but there is a question, anong motor ang pwedeng mag operate DC or AC? So ang tawag sa motor na yon ay universal, no? Universal motor. So this is pwede to siya sa DC and AC na supply. Okay. Next, large squirrel cage induction motors are usually started at a voltage considerably lower than the line voltage to blank. Allow the rotor current to build up gradually. Permit starting under full load. Avoid excessive starting current or obtain a low starting speed. So, na kaya ang tamang sagot nito, no? This is for motor controllers, no? Or motor starters. So, bakit kailangan nating at lower voltage natin i-start ang ating motor? Okay, so parang pare-pareho lang kayo ng answer, ha? No? Okay. So, the correct answer for this one is letter C. No? Avoid excessive starting current. So, this is to prevent our armature, our windings na mag-overload or masunog. So, kasi itong excessive starting current, so like na sinabi ko kanina, ito yung ating lock rotor current, no? LRC. So, i-avoid natin yan so that we could have a lower starting current para hindi masunog yung ating winding. Okay, so we have this next question. So, a DC shunt motor runs at 600 RPM on a 200 volt supply while drawing a line current of 30 amperes. Its armature and field resistance are 0.5 ohms and 120 ohms respectively. What resistance should be placed in series with the armature circuit in order to reduce the speed to 400 RPM? So, assume no changes in the armature or field current. So, we need to find the resistance na kailangan natin i-series sa ating armature, no? Armature winding, para bumaba yung ating speed from 400 RPM to 600 RPM. So, this is one of the probably pinakamahirap na questions, no, sa with regards to these to motors, no, sa maaaring lumabas sa board, no. Okay, so you have 2 minutes, no. Talagang kailangan to ng 2 minutes, and after that we will answer, no. So try nyo muna. So, siguro extend it natin ng 2 minutes, no? Baka haba-haba itong solution nito, no? So, another 2 minutes, no? Okay. Nating i-solve to, no? So we have a DC shunt motor. So kung DC shunt, so yung diagram niyan, so we have here our diagram. So ito yung ating source, so this will be our VS. Tapos meron tayo ditong armature, tapos dito may supply tayo, which is our back EMF, no? Okay, tapos kaparallel yung ating shunt field, no? Winding RSH, no? Tapos yung supply niya is 240 volts, habang ang kanyang armature current or line current pala niya, so itong line current dito yung current ng ating source, so IS natin is 30 amperes. Tapos dito meron tayong armature current, tapos dito naman meron tayong shunt field current. So sa una na circuit, so ang ating speed dito, so the given speed N1 is equal to 600 RPM. So ito, this is 0.5 ohms, habang ito naman is equal to 120 ohms. Okay, so ang question is, ano yung resistance nating isi-series pag gusto nating babaan ng 400 RPM, no? Magiging 400 RPM na lang ang ating speed, no? So ang mangyayari dyan is meron tayong another circuit, no? Ito na yung ating circuit for the So, anong nangyari sa... Okay. So, nawala yata yung connection ko, no? So, sensya na. So, medyo nagluloko ngayon kasi yung ating, ano, internet, no? So, malamang naputol ako dito sa ating pangalawang circuit, no? In which, ang mangyayari na ngayon, ang ating speed ay magiging, into natin, magiging 400, no? 400 RPM na lang. So, tapos ito, meron na tayong circuit, no? Na kukunika natin dito ng R. So, ito yung ating resistance. Isi-series natin sa ating armature. Okay? Tapos, ito yung ating back EMF, no? Plus, minus. So, ito yung ating back EMF. So, ito, hindi na ito magiging katulad nung sa dito nga back EMF sa ating first na circuit. So, ito, siguro, gawin natin itong 2 habang ito naman is gawin natin 1. Tapos, meron pa rin tayo ditong shunt field resistance, no? Na ganun pa rin yung value, which is 120 ohms habang dito naman 0.5 ohms. Tapos sinabi din na the resistance, assuming no changes in the armature or field current. So the same pa rin yung ating ano, ang ating IA, no? Ating IA still equal to 0 ano, armature current natin. So IA pa rin yan pala. So hindi different yung given, no? So natin lang is na bago yung ito yung isi-series, no? Isi-series na resistance. Tapos same pa rin yung ating line current, no? So which is equal to, so equal pa rin siya sa 30 amperes, no? This is our IS. So yung ating ano, shunt, yung ating armature current and shunt field current is the same. So ang tanong, anong value nito? Ito yung hinahanap natin, yung ating R, no? So in order for us to get our R, so para makuha natin, so para makuha natin yung ating R, so all we need to do is to get first what is our back EMF dito. Itong E, no? Itong EB sub 1. So, pwede natin yung makuha if makuha natin yung armature current, no? Kasi yung ating EB sub 1, so that will just be equal to VS minus the armature current times our armature resistance, no? So, kunin natin itong armature current. So, to get our armature current, dapat makuha muna natin yung shunt field current. So, we have ISH is equal to VS over RSH. So, this is now equal to 240 volts over 120 ohms, no? Kasi yung RSH natin is 120. So, that will be equal to 2 amperes, no? Equal to 2 amperes. So, yung ating armature current, so if dito tayo gagawa ng node, node A, so yung ating entering 30 habang yung leaving naman is yung ISH at IA. So, pwedeng sabihin na yung ating IA is equal sa ating IS minus sa ating ISH. So, we have IS natin 30 amperes minus 2 amperes. So, yung ating armature current is equal to 28 amperes. So, pwede na rin itong isubstitute dito. In order for us to solve for our EB1. So, our VS is 240 volts minus our I sub A is 28, no? Yung na-solve natin. Times the armature resistance, which is 0.5. So, we have 240 volts minus 0.5 times 28, that will be 14, no? So, 240 minus 14. Okay, so that will be 200. So, ating EB sub 1 is equal to 226 volts, no? So, yan yung ating EB sub 1. Okay. So, in order for us to Find also what resistance, anong resistance ang ating isisiris dito. Dapat isolve natin itong AB2. Because pag nasolve natin yung AB2, so pwede nating masolve yung ating R. Kasi yung ating armature current dito sa ano sa second condition nating circuit is constant. So 28 pa rin to, no? 28 amperes. So same as our I is H, no? So that is still 2 amperes kasi nakalagay kasi sa problem. Assume no changes in the armature or field current. Okay. So ang ating gagawin ngayon is to find a relationship between our two back EMF, no? So itong AB sub 1 at AB sub 2. So paano natin yung gagawin? So that is by using the relationship also between our back EMF and the speed, no? So kung our AB sub 1 is also equal to the constant of proportionality, if that given, that is equal to 1 times the speed. So if kukunin natin yung ratio natin, no, the ratio between our back EMF sub 1 or AB sub 1 over AB sub 2, so we could say also na yung ratio nila is equal to K N sub 1 over N, KN times KN times N sub 2, no? So mangyayari ngayon, kikancel natin yung K, so we were left with the relationship of AB sub 1 over AB sub 2 is equal to N 1 over N 2, no? Kung balik tayo natin, same pa rin yan. So AB sub 2 over AB sub 1 is equals to N2 over N1. So, pwede yan kasi, equal to sila na ratio, no? So, that is ratio and proportion. So, if we are going now to solve for AB sub 2, no? So, itong AB sub 1, ilipat lang natin dito. So, we have AB sub 2 is equal to AB sub 1 times N2 over N1. So, ano yung ating N2 at N1? So, ang ating N1 is 600 RPM, while our N2 is 400 RPM. Our AB sub 1 as solved, that is 226. No? So we have 226 volts times N2 is 400 RPM over 600 RPM for our N1. So masosolve na natin yung ating AB sub 2. So we have 226 times 400 over 600, no? So this will be equal to 156, no? 0.67. Okay, 156.67 volts. So this is our AB sub 2. So kadalasan pag fraction kasi ang ginagawa ko pag fraction yung nasa calculator ko, no? So, ang ginagawa ko is, inaano ko na lang, sinisave ko na lang to, no? Siguro, share screen ko muna yung kasama yung sa calculator ko. Sabi ito. Okay. So, ang ginagawa ko yung value niyan is sinisave ko lang, no? So, sinisave ko lang. So, shift, tapos ito, store, no? STO or RCL, tapos pindot na ako dito kung aling letters ang gusto kong paglagyan ng value ko na 150.67. So, kunyari sa akin is letter A. Yan. Okay. So, ibig sabihin nun, yung aking 150.67 is nakasave na yon sa letter A. So, para hindi ko na kailangan pang mag drop ng decimal, no? Okay, so meron tayong AB sub 2. Tapos, alam natin na yung AB sub 2 sa ito na circuit, no? Sa circuit na to. So, alam natin na yung AB sub 2 is equal to the VS minus our armature current times, so ito may dalawa na tayong resistance na naka-series. So, that will be RA plus R, yung ating series na resistance, no? So this is 156.67 is equal to 24 minus Kahit ang ating IA is same pa rin, constant, 28, no? Same lang sa ating first na circuit, times 0.5 plus R. Okay. Okay. Tapos, ang mangyayari dyan is ilipat natin itong 240 ba ito? 240 volts yata, no? 240 volts, so we have 156, no? 156.57 minus 240 volts, no? Is equal to negative 28 times 0.5 plus R, no? So, tapos itong 28, kapag nilipat sa kabila, no? So, that will be divide, no? So, 156.57 minus 240 volts over negative 28. Then, this will be equal to 0.5 plus R. So, ito muna i-simplify natin, no? So, we have, okay. So, yung 156 ko, 0.67, bakit naging 57 to? 150 muna natin. Recall A, no? So, 150 pala, no? So, thank you dun sa nag-point out, no? So, this is 150, hindi 156, no? So, this is 150.67. So, yung 6 na points na yan, yung 6 na, ano, na difference, malaki-laki na yan dyan, no? Pag, inano natin sa ating calculations. So, this is 150, not 156, no? Check din natin sa calculator, that is, oops, nag-ano na yung calcul ko. Nag-loading na pala. Okay, ang nangyari sa iyo, bakit ka nag-loading? So ito, i-continue lang natin 'to, no, para kasolve natin yung R. So we have 150.67 minus 240 volts. So over 28. So kahit wala na yung symbol ng volts kasi puro naman yung voltage lahat. So this will be negative, no? Negative 28. Ito ilipatin sa kabila. So we have minus 0.5. So, masosolve na natin yung ating R, no? So, subukan ko lang ulit yung aking calculator. Okay. So, nangyari dyan, we have 150. Well, recall A na lang kasi nakasave na sa A ron, no? Recall A. So, nakasave na siya sa A. Tapos, minus 240 divide negative 28. Tapos, minus 0.5. So, ang value natin is equal to, ano natin, no? Uy, iba pala yung nasa A ko. Bakit na natin 75? Okay, so, nag-ano pala yung calculator kasi nag-start. So, 150.67 minus 240 over negative 28, tapos minus 0.5. Okay, so ang R natin, so R natin is equals to 2.69 ohms, no? So 2.69 ohms, which is letter A, no? So if you notice, so medyo mataas-taas yung solution, no? But basically ito yung kanyang solution, no? So, ang dito lang, so pag ganitong problem, so if you can, so pwede nyo itong isolve ulit, no? So, if you have time, isosolve nyo ito ulit, maybe you could ibahin nyo naman yung mga given natin, no? So, 35 ang amperes, tapos 600, tapos isa 500, no? So, kasi ito yung mga ganitong problem na kadalasang lumalabas sa board exam na to, just to consume your time, no? So, if you have wala kang idea kung paano to i-solve, so iano muna, just continue to the next number, no? Or kasi after nun baka pag may enough time ka pa, tapos binalikan mo to, baka bigla mong maalala, no? Or baka bigla mong magets kung paano siya i-solve, then therefore you could solve naman. So do not spend too much of your time sa mga ganito na problem na medyo matataas yung solution, so that it will not also consume your time, no? So as you notice sa akin din, medyo mahaba-haba yung time ni spend ko to solve this one, kasi kailangan ko pang mag-explain, no? But basically, so kailangan at least 2 to 4 minutes ma-solve yun na yung isang problem, no? If not, so medyo maubos yung problem, yung time nyo sa isang problem lang. So na-miss nyo yung ibang problem na baka sobrang dali lang, no? Sobrang dali lang i-solve. Okay? So for this one, the answer is letter A. So don't worry, itong solution naman is meron tayong copy nito, naka-PDF, tapos yung video din na ito or nating discussion din is naka-recorded, so that you could study it again, no? Next, we have, what horsepower does a 220 volt two-phase motor deliver if it takes 20 amperes and is 90% efficient and operates at 85% power factor? So is it 5.5 horsepower, 4.5 horsepower, 6.5, or 7.5 horsepower? Okay, so again, you have 2 minutes to answer. No? So ito, madali lang to, horsepower lang. So you just need to refresh, no, yung tungkol sa AC power at AC AC power, tapos yung conversion, no, from watts to horsepower. Okay, so 2 minutes. Okay, so time's up. So let's answer this one, no? So ang hinahanap dito is the power in horsepower, no? So we have here our power is equal to single two-phase, no? Two-phase. So pag sabing two-phase, so meron tayong 2E times I, no? Times the power factor times the efficiency, no? So ang ating unit dito is in watts. So, ito muna i-solve natin, saka natin i-convert into horsepower. So, we have 2 times 220 times 20 times the power factor, that is 85%, so 0.85 lang yan. Tapos, the efficiency is 0.9 kasi 90%. Okay. So, we have, so 2 times 220 times 20 times 0.85 times 0.9. Okay. So meron tayong 6,732 watts. So converting this one into horsepower, so 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watts, no? So cancel natin. So we will have, so divide 746. So meron tayong, So the answer is 0.9, no? So 6,732. Tapos 220, check muna natin bakit wala sa choices nung ano answer. So 220 volts two phase times, so 2 times 220 times 0.85 times 0.9, no? Okay, so that is correct. So divide natin ng 746. So 746. Okay, so the correct answer is 9.02, no? 9.02 horsepower. So ang correct answer nito is letter E, no? Because two-phase kasi yung motor. So if in case hindi niyo nalagyan ng 2, no, hindi niyo nalagyan ng 2. So tingnan natin kung hindi niyo nalagyan ng 2. So malamang nandoon yung sagot, no? Yung choices, no? Okay. So this is, kung din divide natin ng 746. So your answer will be equal to 4.5, no? So kaya yung answer dito is B. So you might answer letter B, but remember to, may two phase tayo, no? Two phase. So kaya kailangan meron tayong 2 dito. So the correct answer is 9.02 horsepower. So you could shade, no? I-shade niyo yung letter E. Okay? Next, we have, if 45 kilowatts is supplied to a motor and its output is found to be 54.2 horsepower, so what is the efficiency? So ano yung ating efficiency, no? So you have 2 minutes, no? Okay, so time's up, no? Okay, so let's try to solve this one, no? So yung ating given, no, solution. So yung ating given, the power input, no? So 45 kilowatt yung supply. So this is 45 kilowatt or 45,000 watts. Habang yung output naman, as given, so the power output is 54.2 horsepower. Convert na natin yan into 740, into watts, no? Times 746. This is 1 horsepower. Okay, so we have 54.2 times 746. So this is equal to 40,000 43.2, watts, no? So yung ating efficiency, yun yung hinahanap, so that is power output over power input times 100. So we have 20,433.2 over 45,000, tapos times 100. Okay, so we have, so i-divide na natin yan ng 45,000. Okay, so times 100. Okay, so 89. So the correct answer is 89.85. No, 89.85. So the nearest answer is 90. No, iraw natin yan, 90. So the correct answer is letter C. Okay, so this will be the next one, will be the last problem for tonight. No. So we have this one. So the field and armature resistance of a series 220 volt series motor are 0.2 and 0.1 ohm respectively. So the motor takes 30 ampere of current while running at 700 rpm. If the total iron and friction loss are 350 watts, so we need to determine the motor efficiency. Okay, so what is the motor efficiency? So is it 90.6%, 91.5%, 89.4%, or 92.2%? Okay, so you have 2 minutes to answer. Okay, so times up, no? So isosolve natin to, no? So that we could know what is the answer. Okay, so we have a series, no? Series motor. So kapag series yan, so ito yung ating RSE, the series field resistance. Tapos meron tayong RA dito, tapos dito yung ating back EMF, no? EB. Okay. So dito meron tayong source, which is VS, tapos our current, no, our input current or our IS is equal to 30 amperes, no. So the value of our series field and armature resistance, yung isa ito is 0.2 ohms habang ito naman, so respectively kasi, so the armature is 0.1. But usually the armature resistance is the lowest resistance, no? Yan talaga yung pinaka may pinakamababang resistance, no? So okay. So let's try to find the efficiency. Okay. So talking about efficiency, so dapat meron tayong power input at power output, no? So the power input in our motor is equal to the power taken by our motor from the supply. So meron tayong supply dito, itong ating VS, which is 220 volts. Tapos meron tayong current. So out from that one, we could now solve for our power input. So power input is equal to our VS times our input current, no? So gagawin natin dyan is we have 220 volts times 30, no? 30 amperes, no? So mangyayari, we have 220 times 30. Okay, so we have 6,600, no? Okay, so power input is 6,600 watts. Now, power output, no? Yung power output natin, yan yung output ng ating motor. Or we could just say na yan yung power input natin, power input ng ating motor minus all the power losses, no? Power losses ng ating motor. So ano ba yung power losses ng ating motor? Okay, the usual power losses of our motor is the one is the iron loss, no? Yung losses sa ating ano core, so ating ating body ng ating motor, so mayroon niyang loss. Tapos yung friction, no? Friction loss, because nagarabi naman yan eh, so mayroon tayong heating, so that is friction loss. As for this one, so yung ating ang ano dyan, ang pinaka general term yan is the stray power loss or the P stray. So that is equal to, okay, so ito siya equal to 350 watts, no? Okay, 350 watts. So that will be our stray losses, no? 350 watts. Aside from that, meron din tayong losses due to the resistance of our winding. So ang tawag natin dyan is copper loss, no? Copper loss. So P copper. So P copper loss, so that is equal to our armature, no? Equal to the armature current times the resistance, no? Sa ito, series to, kaya itong dalawa natin, ipa-plus natin yan. So, we have R is E plus R A, no? So, we have now here, 30 amperes yung ating armature current times the series resistance which is 0.2 plus the armature resistance which is 0.1. So, meron tayong, so using our calculator, so this will be 30 squared times 0.2 plus 0.1, no? 0.2 plus 0.1. So this will be equal to 270 watts, no? So our total losses now, so the power losses is equal to the copper loss plus the stray, no? Stray power loss. So you have 270 watts plus 350 watts. So ang total niyan, which is the losses. So we have, yun na tayong 270 plus 350. So this is equal to 620, no? 620 watts. So pwede natin kunin ang ating power output, no? So, power output is equal to the power input minus the power losses. So, our power input is 6,600 watts minus ano yung power losses natin. So, dito, 620, no? 620 watts. Okay, so we have 6,600 minus 620. So, yan yung ating power output. So, 5,980 watts. Then getting the efficiency, so that will just be power output over power input times 100. So you have 5,980 over 6,600 watts, no, times 100. So meron tayong 5,980 over 6,600 tapos times 100. This is equal to 90.61, no? So 90.61%. So this is our efficiency. So the answer is letter A. So letter A yung ating tamang sagot. Okay? So I hope na mayroon kayo natutunan sa gabing ito, no? So yan yung lahat ng ano concept at questions, no? Sample questions for motor and motor controllers, no? So syempre during the your mock board na nasa ating Google Classroom, no? So may mga iba pang question na katulad dito na you will be the one to answer, no? So as of now, share ko muna yung ano dito, yung Google Classroom natin, no? Sana ba yun? Ito. Okay. Share ko na muna pala. So, bago tayo matulog ngayong gabi, no? So, sa lahat na hindi pa nakapasok sa ating Google Classroom, no? So, as of now, meron na tayong 5 MacBoard, no? So, may iba sa inyo is hindi pa sagot sa ating MacBoard, no? Yung iba hanggang simula sa 1 hanggang 5, hindi pa. So, give time, no, to answer the MacBoard. And also, we have also the practice test, no? So, marami-dami din yan, no? So, siguro, 8, no? 8 na yung practice test natin. Ito namang answer sheet, no? So, itong answer sheet, if you want to practice shading, no? Kung gusto nyo mag-practice ng pag-shade, so, ito, no? So, katulad to sa yung mga boxes niyan is almost, no, equal or almost katulad ng nakikita niyo sa pag nag-take na kayo ng board. So itong profile sheet in which you are going to practice how to shade your name, no, yung letter ng bawat name niyo. So dito yan makikita. Habang itong answer sheet naman, so syempre yung answer sheet during the exam. Okay. So tinanggal natin kung kikita ba yan dito, no. So ito yung ano, profile sheet. So surname, first name, middle name, so dapat yan diyan din naka shading yan, no. Tamang shading kasi yung iba kasi nagti-take, ang nangyayari is dito kunyari ang surname is De La Cruz, so dito D, tapos yung na-shade nila na D is dito nasa second na column, no. So yun, maari na yung maka-affect kung bakit baka hindi kayo makapasa kasi siguro tama yung mga sagot nyo pero hindi ma-detect ng computer kung kaninong paper yon kasi ang nakalagay lang kasi sa inyong answer sheet is the serial number. Nakatulad din sa serial number sa profile sheet at doon sa test paper, no, or sa questionnaire. So kapag hindi yon nagtugma, then malamang hindi ma-record yung score nyo at yun pa ang maging dahilan ng hindi kayo pumasa sa board. So practice shading and also always be careful, no, kung mag-shade. At other ano pa diyan is kung pwede huwag niyong tupiin or ano ba magkaroon ng ano magkaroon ng mark yung ano tawag pencil mark or tupi or mabasa yung answer sheet, no, kasi baka hindi niyan basahin ng machine ang magche-check ng inyong answer sheet. So yung MacBoard, no, MacBoard, so all MacBoard are, so sa naka-take na nito siguro alam nyo na all MacBoards are 50 items, no, 50 items, no. So as of now yung MacBoard natin may 5, so if nakasagot na kayo from 1 to 5, so you have already answered 250 questions, no, all for technical subject na question, no. So meron pa tayong dalawang topic for technical subject, which is about transformers and at transformer and substation, at yung last is about power plant, no? So kaya yun pa, so madagdagan pa yan dito sa ating MacBoard, no? Okay, so dito naman yung ating mga previous na mga topics, recordings, no? So at ito yung mga videos na discussion, no? So I hope na you could have time, no, especially sa pag-answer nating MacBoard, at also then practice sa pag-shape, no? Okay, so any questions? So kung may tanong kayo, you could unmute your mic or pwede po kayong mag-chat, no? Chat dito sa chat box. Sa mga walang tanong naman, so you could now leave the Google Meet and let's just call it a night, no? At bukas, we will have the topic for transformers and substation. Okay? So may tanong ba? Okay? So siguro wala nang tanong.
Wala sir, thank you sir.
Okay.
Wala sir, thank you sir.
So,
salamat po, salamat po.
So, maraming salamat sa pagsali, no? Then so maraming salamat. So, I hope bukas is magsama-sama pa rin tayo and have a good night ahead, no? So, thank you and good night.